Have you ever wondered if you're doing the right thing? You want to know you're on the right path and that good things are going to happen in the future. Well, the universe conspires with you to bring you what you want or something better. But you need to stay on the right path to get what you're looking for. If you know what the signs are, you can stay on the path. Listen in to this episode to know what those three signs are to know you are on the right path.
Welcome to Between Heaven and Earth, an internet radio talk show where we help you connect spirit and divine guidance. Lisa Kay, your host, brings you shows that can enhance and transform your life with tips and new ideas for more happiness, abundance, and better relationships. Lisa is an expert on intuition and can show you how to strengthen your inner guidance to empower yourself. Each show is positive and uplifting to inspire your day. Her guest speakers are specialists on self-help, positive thinking, spirituality, and conscious living. Be the best that you can be with Between Heaven and Earth, conscious living for your soul.
So the first sign of being on the right path is that it feels light and easy. So that's number one, light and easy. It flows. It flows seemingly on its own. Have you ever listened to, say, some music and you felt like you were taken away, or you know, your emotions suddenly lighten and you feel happy or you feel content? That's the feeling of flow. So let me share with you the different things that we can do to kind of sense whether we're in the flow or not. So there was, I had this experience where I discovered, and looking back, that I was not in the flow. I once was looking to go see a counselor, and the first time I went to see her, it was in her private home office. And one of the interesting things I noticed was that she had double doors everywhere to her private home office. You had to walk into the door from the outside, and then there was another door that you had to go through to get to the hallway that entered into her waiting space, which had another door that opened into her office. But it really was basically, there were two doors there, which it was a little weird. So looking back on it, hey, you know, that was a sign. And then what she had me do was to engage with her, she had me sign a 5-page contract. I thought, well, that's interesting. I've never had to do that before. And it was, you know, standard stuff. It's like about payments and what to expect and all that, you know. But it was really interesting was by the time I got to the last page, it had a little warning on there that her dog bites. So I thought that, oh, interesting. Okay, so, well, it turned out after a few sessions, it turned out that she was the worst, most paranoid, anxious person that I had ever met. She was a disaster. It was horrible. And so obviously she didn't last long with me. So that is a good example of where it doesn't flow, that it's not light, it's not easy. And perhaps the signs of those double doors saying hard to get to, that's telling you something. So this is an example of one of many, actually, that show you that if there are some odd obstacles or blocks, you know what? That's telling you something. You're not on the right path. And when I get that now, whether I see an odd block that pops up that seems like there's nothing good around or about it, I just go the other way, or I look at it as a sign saying, you know, keep an eye out for if there's another block and then another one and another one. That's telling you, this is not for me. It's kind of like water. You know, water always flows in a way that's easiest for it to move. So that's, you know, if there's a rock, it's going to go around it. If there is a downward slope, it's going to go down the slope as opposed to trying to go upward, up the mountain. It won't do that. That's what we need to do. We have to be in the flow. We have to go where it's easy. You know, and the other thing too is that we start to see opportunities pop up for us. And they might seem, and we're going to talk a little bit more about this later and when we get to synchronicities, but it might be a little odd. But it seems like, wow, these two things could fit so well together. And that may be something that you want to take on. This was something that happened to my son's friend, actually. So Christopher's friend, this was in school, and he was doing a paper on, his friend was doing a paper on Cambodia, which is his birth country during the war. And this friend was obviously here in America, was an adopted child from that birth country, like so many children who had been orphaned or had become adopted because of the strife in the country. Now, it just so happened that he was doing this paper on his birth country, on Cambodia, and specifically about that time, about the wartime and what happened since then. So it just so happened, synchronistically, that we were at a party. The family was there, and we were there with Chris, and we actually met the ambassador to Cambodia, who was instrumental in working with the events after that war. And he was so nice, and he wanted to talk about those times with us. And I knew that he would love to help Christopher's friend with, you know, giving him some input for his paper. And we talked to this ambassador about Christopher's friend, and he said, oh, he'd be very, very happy to help. So Christopher told his friend, and he offered to make that connection. But his friend refused. And he refused out of fear and being timid. Now, it's understandable for someone who's so young, but I just thought, gee, what a tremendous opportunity that he missed. Because what that connection could have done for him in so many different ways. This man was so lovely, and he could have gone deeper with him. He could have gotten some insight into more than he would have read in books or papers. And who knows, it might have helped him in so many ways for his friend's search for identity or knowing where he came from. Hey, and it would have made a great college application essay, right? So he rejected the offer, and I felt sad for him. But this is what we do. Something holds us back. We may think we don't deserve it, or we feel intimidated, or it's something new and unusual. And we become afraid of this big opportunity. It's too big for us. We reject the universe's gift. And when the opportunity first presents itself, we reject our intuition saying to us, do this. Because our thinking mind gets in the way. Oh, that seems way too much. Oh my gosh, that's so out of this world. No, well, that can't be really for me, or I've never done that before. Or what good is that going to do? We talk ourselves out of it, and then we don't do it. We miss the gift. So what we need to do is take a chance and go for it. And you might be surprised. Often we find the next steps often flow even more easily. And when we take that first step, the universe starts to help us with that flow. But you have to take the first step for the flow to keep going. Okay, number two, the second sign is energy and excitement. Now, energy and excitement are great signs to show that you're on the right path. You feel drawn. That's the feeling. So we're going to talk about these feelings and exactly what it is. It's not always jumping up and down and you know, the excitement of, say, a party. But it's this feeling of energy and excitement that your intuition is giving you. So the feeling is that you're drawn. That's the energy. It's a feeling like, ooh, I want to do that. And also along with this is an initial feeling like this, which is like excitement. Oh, what is this? You get a little excited. So when you're on the right path, it's actually like a treasure hunt, because you know you will be led to that treasure that's waiting for you. But you don't know exactly what that treasure is yet. And so that's kind of fun. It's almost like that surprise at the end, right? You open up the treasure hunt box, and then inside you don't know what the treasure is going to be. And that's so exciting. And that's what's exciting about life, when you follow those signs. when you follow that subtle feeling of energy and excitement that's telling you, come on, go this way. Now, remember, the universe is going to give you what you want or something better. You want to put it out there and the universe will deliver. And that's exciting, isn't it? And you have to trust that feeling. And in the beginning, it might be a little hard, but you go with it and see. Remember, everything is a step along the path. So as you're taking that little step, it doesn't necessarily mean that it's going to make everything fall apart. So you can at least say, oh, let's test. Let's take that step. Let's go for it. So remember that intuition feelings are subtle and not super overwhelming. So that feeling of energy is more like each step seems to easily lead to the next one. It isn't quite like being in a frenzy because the energy is more subtle. And the excitement you feel is more a feeling of good anticipation, like going forward, like looking forward to listening to your favorite song again as you turn it on. See, it's subtle, but it's definitely there. Energy and excitement are the signs that you're on the right path. That's number two. Number three is synchronicities happen, like doors are opening all of a sudden where you didn't expect them, or there seems to be something unusual from the norm. Now, you might find that you're walking on the path and you attempt to make something happen. And then there seems to be a little bump or a block to what you wanted. Now, it isn't a straight up no. It just seems like a no. What it's telling you is no, not that now. So when we try to make something happen, we think we know the best way to go. But the universe is telling you the path is going to take a little shift to bring you this or something better. A friend of mine was right out of college and she was looking for a job in a field and a position that she really, really wanted to get into. Now, there weren't many job openings for someone fresh out of school, but she applied anyway to as many of those jobs as she could. And she didn't hear back from any of them. And then one company offered her an interview. Just one. But it was so exciting because it was for a position that was perfect for what she wanted. It seemed like it was tailor-made for her. And she went to the interview and they gave her an offer. But it was for a part-time temporary position. And she wanted full-time. So she was crestfallen. But I told her, you know, take it anyway, because there were too many things that seemed just right, synchronistically being that great fit for her, for her interests and her background. And so she took the job. And within 6 months, they promoted her and they changed her position to full time. So we need to look for those little synchronicities. And we might think the path needs to be this way, or this is just what I want. And if it doesn't fit all those things that I want, then it's no good. I'm not going to go for it. There may be something that's better. And just for my friend, this position turned out to be her dream job. But it wasn't exactly what she thought was going to be what she should be getting in the very beginning. So we have to look for those signs. So the three signs that you're on the path again is, number one is it feels light and easy. It seems to flow on its own like water. Number two, it has energy and excitement that is subtle, right? We don't always, like, all of a sudden it hits us and we're like crazy excited. Sometimes we do, but there may be that subtle energy, that excitement that lifts you up, that gives you a feeling of, I want to do this. This is good. This feels right. And number three, synchronicities happen that are like doors opening, but not always what we kind of expect. You know, there are too many other signs, other synchronistic signs. And I look for those all the time. You know, it's like, oh, well, yeah, it's not exactly what I wanted, but all these other things seem so right. So let's try it. Let's go for it. And I think it just reminded me of Richard Branson's famous saying, who really actually has a multi-billion dollar conglomerate of many, many companies. His saying is, screw it, let's do it. So, and he said that helped him, because without that attitude, he wouldn't have created Virgin Atlantic, the airline, or Virgin Records. So when you follow the signs that you're on the right path, great things can happen for you. What you want is what the universe wants for you. You just need to follow those signs. And these signs come to you in a way that I would say is fueled by that intuitive feeling, that intuitive knowing. And you can look for those signs coupled with your intuition. If you'd like to know how to access your intuition to make great decisions, just go to my website and sign up for the free guide at lmk88.com. I'm Lisa Kay, and you've been listening to Between Heaven and Earth, Conscious Living for Your Soul. Thanks for listening, everybody.